Hello everyone, my name is Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session, we are going to see the different phases in the system development lifecycle. At the end of this session, you will be able to describe the system that exists in a variety of the organization, okay, demonstrate the stages in the SDLC, and critique a system proposal and describe how a feasibility study of the proposed system is carried out and all. Okay, so let's start the session. So first of all, there are six phases in the SDLC. I am using the SDLC word for the system development lifecycle. Okay, so first phase is the preliminary investigation, and second one is the system analysis, third one is the design of the system, fourth one is the development, fifth one is the implementation, and sixth one is the operation and maintenance. So these are totally six phases of the SDLC. So what are these phases and what is actually going on in these phases? We'll see it briefly. So for your understanding, the system is shown in the diagrammatical format. You can see the preliminary investigation. From this point, the start of the procedure, and then it will go in the loop fashion, okay, and it will continue like that, okay. So these phases are the constant, and every development should go through this one. So we'll focus on the first, that is preliminary investigation, okay. In this, what happens is that we actually determine, okay, what is the new system needed, okay. We define the problem statement, okay, and by observing and interviewing with the clients and actually finding out the various things like whom needed, when, where and why, these are most important bits. We are going to interrogate with the client, and then we find out actually what is the problem statement, and based on that we create one short report. So second phase is the analysis of the system, okay. So whatever investigation is done in the phase one, okay, we are going to deep study about that one, okay, and whatever data is gathered in the phase one, we are going to elaborate this one, okay. So during that, the particular things which came into the observation or the interviews, okay, we are going to examine into the formal lines of authority, okay, standard operating procedures, and how the actually information is going to flow in the system, and we have to find out the reasons for any inefficiencies and all, okay. So this was carried out in the system analysis, the second phase, and tools which are used for this one are the mainly four tools are there, which you can see on the screen. That first one is the checklist. You can find out what is the tools used, okay, and otherwise you can go for the top down analysis, okay, and grid charts, software system flow charts. So these are the essential tools which are used for the build up of the system, okay, and in this we are going to build one short report, okay. So for that thing you need to document, okay, whatever the current statement, system and its problem statement, and what are its requirements in the particular tabular format, okay, including this subject, scope, objectives and benefits, okay, and you have to schedule the possible development, okay. So third phase is the design phase. You have to know, find out the investigation, various things during the investigation, and you perform the analysis on that, and based on this, okay, now you can actually design the system, okay, and you have to take care about mainly three things, that it should be economically feasible, technically feasible, and operational. It means actually working, it should be feasible, okay. So tools which are used during this designing procedure is the mainly called as the computer-aided software engineering, okay. So these tools are used to automate the production of information system, and a few example of this one is the diagramming tools, okay, prototyping tool, data repositories, okay, and documentation tools, project management tools are the important examples of this case, okay. And again, we have to build again the documentation. for this designing phase. Okay, see, this is very important one. Okay, you have to document after every phase in the SDLC. Okay, and it plays very important role. We'll see it afterwards. First we'll go to the system design documentation. Okay, it contains alternativize what is the inputs and storage and what is the processing and how the backup is going to take. Okay, and top alternative, okay, which is based upon these are the system fit into the organization. Okay, and flexibility for the future. And third thing is the one of the most important, that is cost versus benefits. You have to manage these things. So this is documented in the design phase. So first question for you guys, that is the documentation in the stages of SDLC is necessary? And if you think yes or no, then you just need to answer why. Okay, just explain briefly your answer. So the documentation is very important phase, because system is going through the different departments during its lifetime, and also in case of the change in the human resources, okay, which are working on the system, it may be get changed. So this documentation plays very important role in that situation. So it is important one. Okay, so next phase is the development phase, and actually during this the developer came into the picture. They developed the software. Okay, write the coding for them, and whatever the hardware is required are actually acquired here, and they are tested the new system also. Okay, they may be first check it module wise, and afterwards integration is done, and integrating testing is done here. Okay, so create manuals for the users and operators in here it is in the documentation phase. Okay, and fifth phase is the system implementation, and here actually the old whatever system you are is there. If not, then no problem. If yes, then it may be get converted, okay, into the new system. Okay, and the users, okay, they are not aware about the new system. They don't know how to handle this new system. Okay, so the users are trained here by the developers or by the trainee of the institute. Okay, they train the user how to deal with this new system, and what are the technologies they acquired and how to use them. Okay, and later on we have to compile the final documentation. Okay, whatever the things we have analysis and whatever the design we have made. Okay, afterwards we have to show them the schedule, and afterwards how the particular things are implemented, what technologies are used for implemented, and afterwards how the user have to take care of this thing. Okay, and we have to evaluate the new system. Okay, so next is phase 5, that is system implementation. Okay, so here user is trained here, and most commonly overlooked here. Okay, so it can be commenced, okay, before equipment delivery, and outside trainers sometimes hired to train the users also. Okay, so it may be get changed from one company to the another one. Okay, so this is in the fifth phase, and types of convergence, okay, we have to take that. Sometimes many approaches are there, that is direct approach, parallel approach, okay, and pilot approach, and next one is the phased approach. So these are various approaches which are used to conversion. Okay, and next one is the sixth, and that is the last, is the operation and maintenance. It is just like a delivery and taking care of the user one. Okay, so this is the last phase, and in this whatever the types of changes are, the physical repairing of the system. Okay, we have to correction whatever. Sometimes what happened, that developer and even the testing team has not recovered any of the issues, but while using them the user will find out some bugs. Okay, and they will report to the manufacturer, then they have to fix it. Okay, so these things are covered up into the phase 6. Okay, and we have to adjust the system to the economical or environmental changes, And this adjustment for the user changing needs also, okay, sometimes the system is good, but during some point a user feel that this should be the changes in this, so that they will feel very relative to this one. So accordingly they have to make changes into this for the comfortance of the user. Okay, at last it is a very important one. And in the evaluations, okay, the system audit and periodic evaluation is done, okay, for the system under the phase 6. So this is the general diagram, okay, for the 6 different phases are shown here, okay. And what is the actually output from the one phase, and actually it is the input to the second phase, to the next phase, okay, that is shown here. You have to go through it, and how the documentation and what are the actually documentation contents in this during the phase changes is shown here. So these are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.